On Facebook, you are welcome. On Joy and G Melody's page, you are welcome. Yes, this is the Arise and Shine Women's Fellowship Sunday service. Yes, we are, we usually, the name of the ministry is, you know, Women's Fellowship, but on Sundays, it is, you know, everyone. And so please don't go away. Join us. We just want to come your way a short time and to, you know, share the word of God with you. The world is a global village now. The world is centered online now. And so we just want to come your way this afternoon so that we can share the word of God with you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord increase you. May the Lord continue to lift you in every area of your life. Last days are dangerous. We are getting to the end of the year, and you need to align yourself in spiritual things. You need to align yourself with God to be able, you know, to perceive or to get what God has for you. Don't wait till 31st night before you start praying, before you start looking out for God. I need you to invite someone. If you are here right now, please share the video. Tell someone that it is on YouTube. Tell someone that the Lord is looking out for them. Tell someone, call someone. Makaradadadadaboya. Lede zebahantayada. We need you to align yourself tonight. We want you to open up. Even as we glorify the Lord tonight, God bless you. I know maybe you are on Joy and G Melodies. We are their parents. And Joy and G Melodies is a part of Arise and Shine. We come together when we want to sing and when we want to share the word of God. And so please join us, even as, you know, we come your way with the word of God. God bless you. God bless you. We want to begin to thank God. The Bible says that in all things, we should give thanks to God. I don't know what you are going through right now. And I don't know what you've been through throughout the year.
Yes.
But I want you to know that it has been by the grace of God. Mommy, you are no more beautiful than those who have gone to be with the Lord, who has lost their lives in this corona, in this season, throughout from January, February up onto this time. You are no more beautiful than those who are there. You are no more, you know, prosperous. You are no more anything than anybody. It is the Lord that showeth mercy. It is the grace of God that you are what you are right now. It is the grace of God. The blood is flowing through your veins at this time. And that is why I need you to be able to acknowledge that fact. Many people go through a lot of things that you have been going through. And they have not been able to stand because they didn't have the grace of God, or they didn't, you know, align themselves with God. But you have been able to survive all the things that came your way because the Lord was with you. The Lord has been your shield. He has been your defender. He has been the lifter of your head. And that is why this afternoon we are coming your way to join you, even as we just spend a short time in the presence of God. I tell you, the psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. It is not going to be a waste of time. Please share the video if you are here. Share the video. Let's get into the word of God. And I can assure you that that word is for you. It's a word in season. It is a word to take you to your next level. It is a word to change your story. Just begin to lift up your voice in prayer. Begin to thank God for your life. Begin to appreciate Him. Hey, I would have done. I would have done. I am not dumb. I am not dumb. It is by the grace of God. I tell you, he deserves the glory. There is no one else like him. He deserves the glory. He is great. He does miracles. He is a good God. The I am that I am. Mega do bazakata tata tayanda. There is no one else. Nakara da 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 yanda. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Makara baziataya. Somebody lift up your voice. Begin to thank God for your life. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to just lift your voice and say, thank you, Lord. It is by your grace, oh God. It is by the grace of God. Yes, maybe this is not what you think you should be watching by now. But I tell you, didn't stumble upon this video for nothing. God has a reason that you have stumbled upon this video right now. If you are seeing us today, if you are hearing it, don't harden your heart. Don't scroll away. The Lord has something for you. Hallelujah. 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 God bless you. We give God the praise. We give God all the honor and adoration. Somebody lift up your voice. Join us this afternoon. Call somebody. Share the video. Our God is faithful. Our God is merciful. Our God is gracious. We give God all the praise. We give God all the honor. We give him the adoration. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Hallelujah. Let's lift, continue to lift up your voice. Continue to, you know, just appreciate God. Like I said, you might not have everything that you wished for right from the beginning of the year, but I want to assure you that God hasn't forgotten you. There are things. He's a God. He's the 11th hour God. He is able to come to your aid at the last minute. So if you haven't seen all that you prayed for, if you haven't gotten answers to all your prayers throughout the year, don't be discouraged. We are here this afternoon to assure you that our God is good, that there is God, and he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord increase you in everything that you do. As you wait upon him, towards the end of the year, may the Lord take you through. May the Lord take you to the end of the year. May he take you across into the new year. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yes, in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we appreciate you. Lord, we glorify you. May your name be praised. Amen. Amen and amen. God bless you all. God bless you all. You are all welcome once more. Please, can you share the video? Let's join together. Even as we enter into the word of God, we promise we are going to be very brief. We want you to just, have a bit of connection today with the Lord. I don't know, maybe you are in Ghana, so you will be able to, go to church. But if you are in England, now you cannot. We have been locked down again. And if you are in America, I don't know where you are, but many countries in the world now are down because of the pandemic. But hey, the word of God, it doesn't have limits. It doesn't have no boundaries. And so God has sent us to you today. Trust me, left to me alone, I'll be sipping some iced tea or some coffee or something right now and watching a movie. But I have been sent to you this afternoon. So please join us, even as, you know, we delve into the Word of God. And without much ado, I would just ask our Papa to zoom into it. Even as you are all welcome, Pastor Mildred, God bless you. God bless you so much. You are welcome. My beautiful daughter, Frema, God bless you. You are all welcome. If I don't mention your name, it's because I haven't seen you. Sister Favor, God bless you. Antia, God bless you. God bless you. Sister Agnes, God bless you. We really appreciate you all. Hey, please tell Helen to take her Bible and her pen to begin to write. God bless you. Please share the video. If you are here, share the video. Tell someone that it is on YouTube as well. Join us this afternoon, even as we zoom into the Word of God. And so without much ado, I would like to give it to our Papa to take us through. God bless you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
We thank God for the gift of life.
Amen.
If you are here with me, count yourself blessed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And know that God has something for you this afternoon. Hallelujah.
I'm very privileged
to be on this platform. Woman of God, God bless you.
Amen.
I am honored to be on Joy and G Melodies, on all the platforms out there.
Amen.
You know, we are not here just to show off or to, you know, say some stuff about us. No, I am here to propagate the gospel.
Amen.
Talk about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And he's the reason for the season.
That's right.
You know, we are gearing towards the end of the world, of the year. And things have changed. And you see, as things have changed, you should also change.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, as our prime minister yesterday, when he was giving the nation's address, he said, if things have changed and the strategy of the virus have changed, they have to also change their approach.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So in the same way as Christians or as human beings, you see, as we are gearing towards the end of the year, and as we all see and know that things have changed, it means that you should also change some things of yours.
That's right.
To fit in. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is what we as human beings are supposed to do, so that when the year turns, we also turn.
That's right.
We are, ladies and gentlemen, we are entering into a new season. From now into the year 2021, we are entering into a new season.
Yes, sir.
Things are going to change.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, change for the best.
Yes,
I'm not even saying for the better. Change for the best. Amen.
Amen.
And seeing that things are changing, you also make effort, put in effort to change.
Right.
Because the Bible declares that it's not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says God.
Amen.
If you say, the day you will say you will pray the more, hey, you will say to yourself, hey, today I'm going to pray 5 hours. That day you will not even open your mouth to pray 5 minutes. You see, so because it is not your will, it is not by your power, it is by the Holy Spirit.
Yes, sir.
So as we are gearing towards the end of the year, we are seeking and imploring and asking the Holy Spirit to help us from now into the new year. For your information, many of us have already entered into the year 2021.
Yes, sir.
It is not only on the 31st that you only enter into a new year. You can enter into the new year whenever you are ready to enter.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if you are in tune with the Spirit of God, you would have already been in 2021 and collecting blessings.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So this afternoon, I've come your way to bring a simple but powerful message onto the body of Christ, so that we will hang on to it and we would not run thirsty and hungry. Hallelujah. So you see, as the year is going to an end, people's hopes are, you know, going down, people are don't know what tomorrow holds for them and all that. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to announce unto you that you see, when there was darkness in Egypt, the Bible declares that there was light.
Hallelujah.
On the people of Israel.
That's right.
In the land of Goshen.
That's right.
In the same country.
That's right.
There were two things happening at the same time. Whilst there was darkness on the Egyptians, there was light in amongst the Israelites. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the same country. So we can be in this pandemic with the world, but we, the sons and daughters of God, light will shine upon
Amen.
You. You shall be the light, and people shall ask you and say, hey,
Amen.
What is your secret?
Amen.
What is going on in your life?
Amen.
And you shall tell them that it is Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, because he is the light of the world. And if we belong to the light, it means we shall also be the light.
Amen.
Hallelujah. As
Amen.
The Bible says it, that we are the light. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, as in this season, that things are changing. Ladies and gentlemen, change.
Amen.
You see, as we eat every day to live, we need spiritual food also to live in the spirit. If you think you can live on this earth with only your physical eyes, then you are joking. You must be balanced.
That's
the
right.
Bible declares that an unbalanced weight is an abomination.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you must be physical and spiritual. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must know. That is why the Bible says, watch and pray. You cannot just pray. You must what? Watch
That's right.
and pray.
Yeah.
Look at the trends of events happening in the world. And pray.
That's right.
That is why when God told Gideon to select an army to fight for him, the Bible declares that over 300,000 people came forward and were chosen, but it was rounded down to 300 people.
That's
Ladies
right.
and gentlemen, look, God is not after quantity. He's
That's
after
right.
quality.
That's right.
You see, as a test, you see, the reason why it was rounded down to that small figure was as a result of a test.
Right.
God, in this life, you would undergo tests and trials.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as they went through the test, the Bible declares that a majority of them were drinking with their whole heads and their own all focus upon the water that they were drinking. But the Bible declared that a few, only a few, were drinking ready to fight with their swords drawn out and watching out for the enemy. Hallelujah. God is seeking the preparedness of his body,
That's
of
right.
the church. Hallelujah. We are not supposed to be just like ants who, when the leader goes in one direction, you see all of them heading towards the same direction. The direction. No, we are supposed to be watchful
That's
and
right.
prayerful.
That's
Praise
right.
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So this afternoon, I'm bringing your way that what I'm bringing your way this afternoon is that train your spirit.
Amen.
As you are training your body,
My
you
God.
Go to the gym,
My
you
God.
Go do exercises here and there, you eat to feel good and to feel the strength you
yes,
need
sir.
For your day in, day out activities, but we forget our spiritual nourishment.
That's
we
right.
need spiritual nourishment to make it on this earth.
That's
that
right.
is why I say balance. There should be a balance.
That's
we
right.
that is why sometime in the Bible you can be a Christian but yet carnal.
That's right.
It is possible. You can be a tongue-talking Christian but you are carnal. You are carnal when it comes to your operations in your lifestyle and the things you do. Praise the Lord. So you see, God wants us to be spiritual. As he is spirit, the Bible says the God that you and I serve, he is spirit. So as we want to relate to God, we must be what? Spiritual.
That's right.
The fact that we are on this earth means that we need food to survive.
Mm-hmm.
The body needs food. It needs nourishment. But as we are on this earth, because we are spirits, we need spiritual food to survive spiritually.
That's
Hallelujah.
Right. Amen.
That is why our God did not leave us vagabonds. He did not leave us destitute. He left us with something to help us to be nourished in the spirit, so that we shall be balanced human beings.
That's
when
right.
it comes to physical food, we can eat and be nourished in the body.
That's right.
And to keep the body strong, to house the spirit.
That's
Hallelujah.
Right. Amen.
So the balance is very much important.
Mm.
So the Bible makes it clearly to us that we must train our spirit.
Mm.
So as much as we eat every day to live,
mm.
we must feast on the word of God every day.
That's
to
right.
train our spirits up.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Mm.
The first scripture that I will be checking out, it can be taken from 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7 and 8.
Mm.
It says, but refuse profane and old wives' fables.
Mm.
All that it means is, you know, we should detest and to get rid of godless myths and unnecessary, you know, things in our lives. You see, and exercise thyself rather unto godliness.
Mm.
So our lives styles are supposed to be, you know, exercised unto godliness. You see, so we need our spirits to be exercised. Praise the Lord. And how can we exercise our spirit? It's by going according to what the word of God is telling us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because if you go down, it goes on verse 8. It says, for bodily exercise profiteth little. If you are a macho in the body and in the physical,
mm.
and you are lanky and very weak in the spirit,
mm.
what is there?
Mm.
It is nothing.
Nothing.
The Bible declares in the Bible that on the day of your adversary, I think it's Proverbs 24:10. It says, in the day of your adversary, in your trials and temptations, if you fail, it means what? Your spirit is weak, or you are weak. You are a weakling. In the day of your fight, imagine you being going for war, and on the day of your war, you just crumble and fall. What does it mean? It means you are defeated already.
Yes.
You are finished. You are gone. You are a goner. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But that is not the case of us. The reason why God wants us to be on top and in charge is because he knows that at a point in time in our lives,
mm.
there may come a time that the enemy will strike you.
Yes.
And as he strikes you, because you are spiritually fed and you are nourished
mm.
in the spirit,
mm.
On the day of your adversary,
okay.
you will be strong.
Yes.
And you can stand tall.
That's right.
And face him squarely.
Hallelujah.
Tete a tete. Our face and defeat him.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if you do not exercise your spirit
mm.
and nourish your spirit,
mm.
when the day of adversity comes,
mm.
for surely it will come.
Yes,
every human being on this earth, in one way or the other, you will face challenges,
yes,
circumstances, difficulties.
Mm.
And when that day comes,
mm.
you will need your spiritual strength. And the Bible says on that day,
mm.
if your spirit is weak, you are a goner.
Yes,
but tofiakwa, that when that day comes, we shall be weak. No,
Amen.
We shall stand strong.
Amen.
Why? Because we are nourished with the word of God.
Mm.
We are infused with to capacity to the extent that when we open up our our mouths is Shanda, Kabranto, Kadi. And we shall decree and declare to change circumstances and situations in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For bodily exercise
profited little.
But godliness is profitable unto all things.
My God.
Listen, all things. So if you think you are okay in the spirit and that you have everything in that a person should have, the houses, the cars, the everything, it is limited, my brother, my sister.
Yes.
It is not something that you should brag about. But if you are charged up in the spirit and exercised in the spirit, the Bible says it is profitable unto all things.
All things.
All things. It covers all things. Imagine you are a spiritual bulldozer and you have your staff, and the enemy, you have sensed within your spirit that the enemy is after your goods. What do you do? You stand your ground, sir.
Amen.
And to decree and declare, hey devil, take your hands off my family, take your hands off my staff, and you bind and break him off your back in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But in case you imagine you have everything you need on this earth and you are weak in spirit and you don't have what it takes to stand your grounds, and the enemy strikes you,
Do
you think would happen? Oh, Makanto Bahade, you are finished.
You see
the same thing happened in the life of Job. Because Job depended on God, the Bible declared that God created an hedge around Job and his family, businesses, his everything. So he relied on God as his master, protector. He was protected. Hallelujah.
Right.
That is why the enemy could not break forth on him. You see, but when he went through his test, what he was a God, the Bible was trying to tell us was that without God,
we are nothing.
Hallelujah. God, the God had confidence in a man called Job. The same way he has confidence in you today, Ajua. He has confidence in you today, Agnes. He has confidence in you today, Jeremiah. He has confidence in us.
My
as
God.
His sons and daughters, he knows that because we rely on him and that we are spiritual, we can overcome everything.
That's right.
And the things that come our way, even if they come and we do not understand them and we are being challenged, the Bible declares that as we cry out unto the God, our Lord, the God who sees in secrets and who knows all the things that the skirmishes and the tricks of the devil. The Bible declares that as the wickedness of the wicked was being performed under the sun, the Bible declares that God sat upon his throne and he laughed at their wickedness.
Right.
Why?
Right.
Because he saw what they were doing. Nothing can outsmart God.
Hallelujah.
That is why we must rely on him so that in the day of our adversity, our test and trials, we shall prevail.
Hallelujah.
We shall succeed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Having promise of the life that is now and of that which is to come. You see, apart from we being strengthened in our spirit, if you are strong in the spirit, you shall overcome all things, and you will be in charge of the world now and of the world to come. Why? Because, ladies and gentlemen, you are an eternal being.
That's
you
right.
do not die. You must understand this. When a person dies out of this body, he is not dead. He has transited into another place.
That's right.
And it is our choice here on this earth when to choose where we choose to go. That's where right. We want to go, we must choose today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's either you choose eternal life to spend eternity with God or spend eternal damnation
That's
in
right.
hell.
That's
it
right.
is up to us to choose. That is why when a person dies in the body, it is only the body which is dead. You, the spirit. Spirits don't die.
That's right.
Spirits are eternal. And they go where they have chosen to go.
That's
if
right.
you choose God, you will go back to God and to enjoy in his bosom. If you rebel, you will go to some place called hell. And that is where the damnation is.
My
so
God.
Spirits don't die. So as you are sons and daughters of God, listen to me and to train your spirit so that in this end times we shall be found, you know, worthy of
That's
him
right.
on this
right.
earth.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see, we need to train our spirits. We cannot do it by ourselves.
No.
For your information, we cannot do it.
Yes,
let's
sir.
Look at Psalm 143 verse 10. Psalm 143, Makariete ta 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 ta, verse 10. I'll read. He said, teach me to do thy will.
My God.
You see, we are supposed to be taught to do the will of God. You cannot do it by yourself.
No.
We need teaching. But it is so sad to say that many of us don't have teachable spirits. They are too known. When you open up to teach them, they think that they know more. And such people don't find themselves wanting. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, you cannot just forgo the teachings of the Holy Spirit. He says, teach me to do your will, for thou art my God. You must know and understand where you come from. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lead me into the land of uprightness.
My God.
If God, the Bible says, if God doesn't call you, you cannot come.
That's right.
The reason why you call yourself a Christian is because he has called you.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as he has called you, mellow yourself. Be humble. That is why humility goes a long way, to say that the meek shall inherit the earth. That is the meaning. That if you are humble and you are humble enough, the Bible makes it clearly that you have what? A teachable spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you can handle spiritual stuff. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And as he teaches you, he will lead you in uprightness.
My God.
You cannot teach somebody who doesn't have a teachable spirit. It's
My
impossible.
God.
Imagine you teaching somebody who thinks he knows it all. It's impossible.
Yes,
you just keep quiet and just look at the person throwing his weight about.
That's right.
But we are to what? Humble ourselves to have a teachable spirit.
My
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that we, oh my God, Holy Spirit, I thank you. Do you know that we all have been children before?
Yes, sir.
We know childhood. We know what happens in childhood. But ladies and gentlemen, even Methuselah, the oldest person on earth who once lived, doesn't know it all in the spirit. Never. Because the spirit world is very vast. It's a vast expanse that even the oldest man that lived almost to about 1,000 years could not fathom the spiritual world.
That's
it's
right.
impossible for you to understand spiritual things. So if you think you know it well, you know nothing. Because in the spirit, we do not know it all.
That's
that
right.
is why we need God, who is all in all.
That's
who
right.
knows it all.
That's
the
right.
all-wise God.
Yes,
to teach us
yes,
into spiritual what? Truths. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we have all become children. But we have not all become all what it takes in the spirit.
Yes.
So we need teaching. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we must train up our spirit. So that we must have a teachable spirit to be trained. So that we can communicate,
That's
fellowship.
Right. That's right.
And draw close to our God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we check Galatians 5:17, Galatians, the book of Galatians 5:17, the Bible declares that, hey, he says, for the flesh lusted against the spirit. Look, that is why, look, you can never be a spiritual Christian and still love carnal things. Even though there are spiritual, there are Christians who love, who live carnally. They think that is all. Yeah, it's just enough for you to go amen and come and sit down and that's it. That is all there is. No, there is, the Bible declares that the body lusted, it fights against spirituality. Whether you like it or not, or whether you like it or yes, your body will fight your spirit. The first fight that happens in a person's life is not between you and somebody. It's between your body and your spirit. Because whilst your spirit wants to grow and get nourished to know things of God, your body is saying, hey, I am on this earth. I need nourishment. I need to chill. I need that parties. I need to, you know, feel good. There is this conflict between your body and your spirit. So there is a fight already within you. So if you do not train your spirit, your body, who is already in his place of domain, that is on this earth, will overpower your spirit. You must understand this. So God knows this because, hey, we serve the all-wise God who knows it all. He knows tomorrow from even today. Hallelujah. He knew that, hey, as we are on this earth, there will be a fight. So he is entreating us. He is warning us. He is showing us that, hey, the flesh, your body, will fight against the spirit. And the spirit will fight against the flesh. Why? Because maybe you want to be spiritual. Haven't you felt this before, that you are a Christian, and you, some time ago, you remember, our friends came from the United States and they took us out, and where they took us, people were partying, dancing, and we were just sitting there, so lost. We didn't even know what to do, and we were like, nah, we are in the wrong place, because the things people were doing, we were not comfortable with it. Hallelujah. Amen. So that is when you know that your spirit, the Holy Spirit, is putting in check your spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he says, these are contrary to the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. So you see, the first barrier to being spiritual is your flesh. It's not Satan. It's your flesh. It is your feelings, your emotions, your senses, your sensuals that you want to feed. You want to feel good. This body wants to feel good in his domain. He wants to chill. He wants to go out and fellowship with friends in drinking, in, you know, doing some stuff. But your spirit is saying, that is not what you are supposed to do. So if there is this conflict between you, within you, that you must put in check. You see, as you nourish the spirit, your body would have to just follow. It would align. It would just follow. Hallelujah.
My God.
But as the day you stop praying, that is why consistency is very much important.
That's right.
As we continue to listen, do you know that the day if you are praying every day and you leave it one day and you continue the following day, you still go back to where you started from. It is something that the flesh or the body is fighting against spirituality in our lives. We must understand this. That is why consistency breaks bounds. Consistency breaks barriers. It breaks yokes. It breaks forth. It can take you to some heights of spiritual, tenacity you have no idea. That is why we must fight this good fight of faith, the Bible says. Well, how do we fight this good fight of faith? It's by being spiritual. And how can we be spiritual? I'll give it to us in a minute. Hallelujah. We must be spiritual to train our spirits to submerge or to make their body submit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. So, in the book of Job, I was talking about it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Listen to what he says. Chapter 32, verse 8. Mm. What did he say? He says, he says, but there is a spirit in man. And the inspiration of the Holy Spirit,
my God,
the inspiration of the Almighty, giveth that your spirit understanding.
That's right.
So for you to understand life to its fullness, you must get spiritual understanding.
That's right.
Your spirit man must be nourished by the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
That is where the nourishment comes from.
Amen.
There is a spirit in man.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, We need the Holy Spirit.
Mm.
We need him to be nourished.
Mm.
We need him to teach us so that we will understand life.
Amen.
We will, with the Holy Spirit, we will understand that life is spiritual and life is also physical. We would understand that it is out of the spiritual came the physical life.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We would understand that it is the spiritual who rules.
My God.
And the physical just, you know, manifests.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, it is not, hey, you can have somebody who has it all, but it's a chicken in the spirit.
Yes,
nah, I don't want it that way. I want to be an eagle and a lion in the spirit. So that it doesn't matter if I'm a chicken in the physical. I want to be a lion in the spirit. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When you check 33 verse 4, he says, the spirit of God has made me. Job is saying, he says, the spirit of God has made me, and the breath of the Almighty has given me life.
My God.
You must understand that it is the breath of God in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must understand that it is the breath of God that made you.
Yes, sir.
You are full of it.
Hallelujah.
And out of that, if we are to get spiritual nourishment or attainment, we must just kowtow to the Holy Spirit for him to teach us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the book of Titus, Titus chapter 2, my God, verse 11 down. It says, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men. What is that? He is called Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus Christ came for all men.
Amen.
But it's rather unfortunate. Some men and women have chosen him. Hallelujah. And have accepted him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Teaching us that denying godliness and worldly lusts, for us to be trained, for us to attain some spiritual position, we must deny ungodliness and worldly lust, what this body loves doing.
Mm-hmm.
We must deny that. We should live soberly. You see, it means you should put your body under control of the spirit, righteously in line with God's commandments, and godly in this present world. You see, all the scriptures that I have brought across talks about this present world and stating the fact that we must be spiritual, godly, righteous, and all that. It means he wants us to understand that our lives here on this earth is much more physical than we think. Hallelujah. So we must understand that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we need to understand the word of God so that we can go we can attain some spiritual heights in the spirit.
Amen.
My last scripture, then I am done. Hebrews 5:14. It says, but strong meat belongeth to them that are full of age. This has nothing to do with food. If you think I'm talking of steak here, you see, then you are mistaken. I'm not talking of steak. Meanwhile, to steak is very nice. But I am not talking about steak. I am talking about the fact that spiritual maturity is very important.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Babies drink milk.
Yes.
If as they grow, they eat meat and solid foods. Mm. That is how a Christian's life should be. You started from A, you progressed upwards, and now you are eating solid meat and breaking bones and sucking the bone marrows from bones.
Hi.
Hallelujah. And he says, it belongs to them that are full of age, full of the Holy Spirit. If you want spiritual truths, you must be spiritually matured.
That's right.
Spiritually matured to take in, to understand some spiritual truths. Hallelujah. And it goes on to say, even those who by reason of use have their senses, listen, have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil.
My God.
Makutu patupa. It is when you have attained spiritual maturity,
right.
You have been trained in the spirit,
hallelujah.
You have taken in the spirit,
that's
and
right.
You understand it. That is when you can discern.
Yes.
You can discern,
hallelujah.
Stuff. You can discern whether something is good or bad. You can discern situations, circumstances. When you get to a place, to a country, to a place, you can discern and know and understand the spirit that is dominating in that place.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm just going to give some three simple things that we can do to train our spirit. We know it already, but I am just mentioning them because it goes well and fits well with my message. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, on how to train your spirit, you must what? Feed on the word of God and meditate on it. It is not enough to just read. You must study and meditate. What is it to meditate? Is to think on what you have read and ask the Holy Spirit to bring light to it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we need that to train our spirit. Secondly, we must pray more in the spirit.
My God.
He says, pray in the physical and pray also in the spirit. We need spiritual, you know, the more you pray in the spirit, the more you become sharp,
right.
In the spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He says, pray with understanding and pray in the spirit.
Yes,
we
Lord.
Need to be balanced.
Mm.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And also, we must exercise our spiritual, maturity or our spirituality in following the promptings of the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
You must practice it.
Yes, sir.
If you say you are a Christian, there may come a time somebody will come and say he or she is sick. You must believe in the God you serve that you are anointed.
Yes,
and
sir.
Pray for that person for healing.
Yes, sir.
Believe God for healing.
Mm.
Trust God for healing. Hey, you may meet a dead person and you will be found there. And the Holy Spirit will say, pray and resurrect that person.
Yes,
believe in yourself and pray for that the resurrection of that person.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So it is for us to train our spirit as we about to enter the new year. My information or my message to the body of Christ is to train your spirit.
That's right.
For tomorrow. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Today, my God, makadibi sikata. Today is in the light. Tomorrow is in darkness. But it is only when you rely on me, the Holy Spirit, light will shine upon
Hallelujah.
You in tomorrow, that you would understand tomorrow. If you know today, you don't know tomorrow.
No.
The only person who can help you know and understand tomorrow, next year, is the Holy Spirit. Train yourself from now so that your eyes will be open in the next year.
That's
your
right.
senses will be open in the next
That's
year
right.
for you to know what lies my ahead God. In the
my
next
God.
Year.
My
Hallelujah.
God. Amen.
So this is my message to the body of Christ, that as we are entering 2021, it looks foggy. It looks unpromising. It looks shaky. People are afraid. There is no hope. But with God. But they that know their God, they shall be strong and do exploit.
Hallelujah.
Ladies and gentlemen, your exploit lies ahead of you. You can do exploits in tomorrow.
My God.
Hallelujah. From now into your tomorrow,
yes,
into
sir.
Your next year.
Yes, sir.
If only you would train up your spirit.
Hallelujah.
Be so much fellowship with God, the Lord your God. You can face tomorrow
Hallelujah.
Squarely. And you will live a glorious life in the year 2021.
My God.
This is my word of God to you. That you stay strong.
Yes, Lord.
Meditate on the word.
Yes, Lord.
Read, study the word. Pray in the spirit. Exercise your audacity and power in the spirit. And see God use you for miracles, signs, and wonders. You are blessed.
Amen.
In this week, as we are. We are beginning a new week. If you are out there listening at the sound of my voice and you need help spiritually in your body, if there be any challenges in your body, in your soul, in your spirit, you need some healings, you need some balancing, I pray, may the Holy Spirit that sees everything bring balance
Amen.
In your body,
Amen.
In your soul,
Amen.
In your spirit,
My
in
God.
Every area that you need
My
God,
God,
may He visit
Amen.
You in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I thank you
thank
for
your
word
you,
that
Lord.
You have given me
Us,
for your people.
Yes, yes,
we
Lord.
Thank you
thank
that
you.
As we have taken upon our lives to be of a teachable spirit, Father, you teach us your
yes,
will.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
For us to cling on to you.
Yes, Lord.
So that you will show us great and mighty things in tomorrow.
My God.
So that our lives shall be exemplary
yes, Lord.
Unto the world.
Yes, Lord.
And the world will flock into
Amen.
You. Father, we thank you
thank
in
you,
Jesus'
Lord.
Mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Come breathe in me all my life. Take over, come breathe in me, and I will rise. I'm gonna rise on eagle. Somebody sing with me. Come breathe in me. Oh. Take over, oh, come breathe in me, and I will rise, I'm going to rise on eagles. Come on, come breathe in me, I'm telling you. By your mind, staying in the spirit, controlling yourself, your
Jesus.
Flesh will not be by your mind.
It's not.
It
your
will
mind.
Be by the power of the Holy
yes,
Spirit.
Lord.
For you to be spiritual, it takes the Spirit of God
yes,
to
Lord.
Hold you, and that is why we are singing this song. On eagle. breathe in me. Somebody say, all my life, take over. Come breathe in me, and I will rise. I'm going to rise on eagle's wing. Oh, let your living waters flow over my soul.
Come on.
Begin to say that, help me, Lord. Help me to be able to focus on the Spirit. Help me to be able to stand in you. Help me, Lord. Not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit of the Lord. Somebody open up. Yes, you have been trying. The Spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Hey, shout unto the Lord.
Spirit.
Thank you, ministers. Joy and G.
Spirit.
One more time we say, let your living waters flow over my soul. Somebody pray. Pray that the Spirit of God will strengthen you. Not the things you say you don't want to do. That is the ones that you do. I tell you, it will not be by you. Pray tonight. As we are here, we are agreeing with you. Let the Spirit of God take over. Let the Lord help you. For by strength shall no man prevail. Jesus, come on. Hey. My God, Tarabo Zekapaha. I tell you, it will not be by your might.
Not by your might.
I am telling you, many of us, we had New Year resolutions. We always do these things.
Yeah.
And that is why Abeye normal Kramenipa. Maybe why you want, why you be a and so jaye nyai. You've done a lot. You've tried that. You've tried Hinduism. You've tried Islamic. You've tried Christianity. Your spirit is wailing. You are searching for some truth. But I want you to open up unto the Lord tonight. This right now, even as you are with us, if you are listening to us and you don't know Jesus, you don't know Christ, I want you to lift up your voice with me tonight. Say that, Lord Jesus, I have heard a lot about you. In 2021, I am not going to go by myself. I am praying this afternoon.
Yes, Lord.
Forgive me my sins.
Yes, Lord.
And come and be with me. Teach me your ways. Direct my path.
Amen.
Show me things that I do not know of, so that I will be able to stand in you. I will be able to fulfill my destiny in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you.
We thank you.
Father, we give you glory.
Amen.
Honor and adoration.
Amen.
Empower us as we enter into the new year.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We have prayed with thanksgiving.
Hallelujah.
And everybody shall say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hi, my God. This is so refreshing. If you don't like this, then I don't know what you like. If you don't like this, physical things doesn't last too. You eat the best food that you say you like. Mm. And see in the next, you know, maybe 1 day or 2 days. And see where it will come from.
Mm.
And so if you don't like this refreshing hour of hope, hour of glory, then I don't know what you like.
Mm.
But like, you know, we are all saying it will profit you good.
Mm.
It will do you good.
Yes, Lord.
To align yourself with Christ.
Mm.
There are many people that has been struggling. That last year, January, you made resolutions.
Yeah.
Many of us couldn't finish.
Mm.
Why? Because our spirits are weak.
Mm-hmm.
The flesh is willing. And so you see people doing certain things, sinning and many of us, we are like, oh, I told him I don't like that. By the time I realized I was pregnant, mommy, the spirit is weak. I said it, I was confessing to myself, I shall not die, I will not be sick. And by the time I realized I was sick, the doctor said, I'm going to, mommy, be spiritual and have that spiritual tenacity.
Tenacity.
And what did the man of God say? For you to have that spiritual tenacity, you need to be well vested in the word
in
of
the
God.
In the word.
Make it part of your resolutions. Since the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God has suffered violence. The violent shall take it by force.
Yes,
you cannot afford to remain like that in 2021. Mm. And that is why you need to shine your eyes.
Mm.
Have that spiritual strength. Look for God. Seek him and ye shall find him. Many of us are seeking different things.
Oh, yeah.
We are seeking cars. We are seeking husbands. Mommy, if the husband comes and he's not spiritual,
you are dead.
If the wife comes, I saw that beautiful lady. Oh, riding at night. The way she walks. Oh, she's so sweet. I want to marry. Mommy. This word of God, it says that. No man.
After the flesh.
Kadubra sakata. No man after the flesh.
No man.
So with all the things you are seeking for, with all the things you are doing, if you don't seek God, mommy, it can all vanish in one day. Didn't you hear the story of Job? All his wealth went one day, even though it was God who gave it to me and God was protecting it.
Mm.
But at a point, when the enemy stepped in, all of it went away. That is why, but his spirit was still strong.
Still strong.
He still had that relationship
that
with God.
That is why God
and
blessed him.
And that was what sustained
ten
him.
10 times more.
We are not in good times now. Nobody should tell you. If you are in England, we are locked down.
Yeah.
Now, this Christmas, we are spending on our own. We have been locked down. You cannot go and walk around town.
No.
In these times, if you don't have God, there's been a level of mental health.
Yeah.
Things that has increased. Why? Because they don't have something that they can hold on to.
And domestic
in
abuses.
Times like this.
Yeah.
Mommy, we are going to go into so many things in the new year, in the coming year. It is not bread and butter.
Mm-mm.
It is not going to be hunky dory. Yonky dory. It's not going to be like that.
Yeah.
The sooner you get it, the better.
The better.
But it will take those who know their God.
Those who know their God.
It means those who are strong in the spirit that will be able to go through it. And that is why we have come your way.
Mm.
The man of God has said a lot. When I come in, I am just brushing around, telling you. That, you know, he preaches deep, okay? I want to break it a little. So that those of us who are like me, you will understand what we are saying. Seek God. Watch and pray.
Mm.
And for any kind of 2021, me aweni, na shu shu eradi e chiri pa. Sen ye ba ye eradi be so mu, no di we chumri kasa abu okore. God bless you. God bless you all. I really appreciate you all. Sister Yechan, God bless you so much. Sister Juliet, Pastor Mildred, we really appreciate you. God bless you and our Norway family. God bless you all. Okay. God bless everyone who has been supporting us throughout the year. We really appreciate you. All, you know, we are doing is to try and get all of us together so that we, you know, we stand in these times like this. Without you, without us joining together, we might not be able to stand when some things come our way. Mm. Therefore, God bless you all. God bless you all so much. Mm. And like I said, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. I'm seeing some things that I don't want to comment. Sister Favor, God bless you. God bless you all.
Rebecca.
And if you are on Joy and G Melodies platform right now on YouTube and on Facebook, trust me, they've got a lot of things in line for you. They are preparing so much for Christmas time. You know, when I'm entering their room, when I'm entering their room, they shut the door. They close it because they say that, as for mommy, she will spill the surprise. So, it's not me. The spirit is willing, but the flesh, they are preparing for all of you so much. So thank you for everyone on Joy and G Melodies platform and on, YouTube for your support and your prayers for them. They are doing, you know, a lot to come and celebrate the Christmas with you. So God bless you. Pastor Seth, we really appreciate your presence here today. God bless you. My beautiful daughter, Cora, God bless you. As usual, I appreciate you. But today you were not the first. Hey, my daughter. Be careful. Don't let Auntie Agnes overtake you. Merry Christmas to you too, my beautiful daughter. And my love to Jasmine. God bless you. Hey, Helen, I know you are watching. Auntie Teresa loves you. Mwah, 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 mwah. And Jeremiah loves you so much. Ewa loves you so much too. God bless you all. Sister Lillian, God bless you. God bless you so much. Yes, I really miss you, I miss you. God bless you. We really appreciate you. And without much ado about nothing, we want to say that this week, may the Lord show you great and mighty things that you do not know.
Yes, Lord.
May the Lord open doors unto you.
Jesus.
May the Lord cause you, show you great things in His way.
Amen.
May the Lord give you that spiritual strength.
Amen.
That you will be able to stand in
Jesus
the coming
name.
Year. May the Lord cause men to favor you.
Amen.
In this Christmas, in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
May the angels of God encamp around you.
Amen.
May they protect you.
Amen.
By the reason of the blood of Jesus,
Amen.
Let there be a Passover concerning
Amen.
You. If there be any evil that is being planning around your area, around your family, whatever thing,
Mango.
Let the blood of Jesus protect
Jesus.
You and your family. In
Amen.
The name of Jesus.
Amen.
And now may the peace of God.
That
surpasses all understanding.
My God.
May it rest and abide with you all now and forevermore.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And
amen.
Amen. God bless you. God
amen.
Bless you.
Amen.
We really
amen.
Love you all.
Amen.
See you all soon
amen.
On Christmas, right? On Christmas with Joy and G Melodies. God bless
hey.
You all.
All right.
God bless
okay.
you.
Okay.
Yeah, so you want to shut me up. God bless you. Join Jewel. I will be coming your way soon.